wrestling fans, and welcome to AIWF Mid-Atlantic Wrestling. I am Rick Deezel. What is Jimmy Love's obsession with Chris Armstrong? Now, for those of you who have been watching AIWF Mid-Atlantic Wrestling, you know that every time the AIWF Mid-Atlantic goes anywhere near Pelham, North Carolina, which is quote-unquote Chris Armstrong's strong area, he has a large fan base there. But it's like every time AIWF Mid-Atlantic goes anywhere near Pelham, Jimmy Love goes into this weird obsession mode. Now, as you've seen on last week's program, Jimmy Love come out once again. Now, don't get me wrong. In Jimmy Love's defense, Chris Armstrong is walking on a cane. He has had surgery on his back due to an injury. Now, the fact that he's walking on a cane should automatically tell Chris Armstrong, stay away from a wrestling ring. But now, on the other side of the coin, on last week's episode, all he was doing was coming to the ring by request to give the fans an update on his injury and how he's progressing along with his recovery. But as always, in Pelham, Chris Armstrong could not finish a sentence, hardly, before Jimmy Love and the old school mafia makes an appearance. Now, granted, as always, the old school mafia is following along behind Jimmy Love. He's always leading the charge when it comes to Chris Armstrong. Jimmy Love is always the one who has all the issues. He has everything that needs to be said. It's always the rest of the old school mafia who is tagging along and helping Jimmy in this crusade he has against Chris Armstrong. Let's go back to last week, right now, and take a look at a few of the things that was said and what happened when Jimmy Love, yet again, confronted Chris Armstrong in Pelham, North Carolina.
I hear you out here running your mouth about your back's all hurt. And you're crying the blues about how, I had to have surgery. And Jimmy Love done went crippled me. And I live in a trailer down by the river. You want to bring up bad memories for Jimmy Love? Maybe I'll bring up some bad memories for you, huh?
See right there, once again, Chris Armstrong just minding his own business, coming out in the ring to give the fans an update on what's going on with his injury, how he's progressing along with his recovery, and here comes the old school mafia once again to attack Chris Armstrong. Now, as you also seen, there's the guys from the back who's totally fed up with this. Cold Cash D, Jersey Kid, and the new kids on the block, I guess you could say. The boys from up north, Tropic Thunder. Now, we cut the video off right there because I want to talk to you just a couple more minutes about this thing. What happened next took the old school mafia completely by surprise. Chuck King, who has not been seen in the AIWF Mid-Atlantic area in a few weeks, and we'll get into that a little bit later on the program, but Chuck King made an appearance at ringside. And he had a few choice words to say for the old school mafia. Let's go back now and take a look at what Chuck King had to say.
Let's start out with Louis Moore. Your championship's in the middle line. I hope you got it stacked up nice and perfectly, boy. Because your match tonight will be versus the Jersey Kid. Trey Thompson. The man of kind of. Man,
like you said, don't you forget.
Shined up real well because I know you still have them. You haven't lost them. You've been holding on to them in every means possible. Let's go with a tag team title match with Keikoa and Sebastian Cruz. Hands got some Jimmy Love. We'll be going up against the man, Cold Cash Keith.
Well, there you go. Chuck King laying the law down, setting up a series of matches with the old school mafia and the guys in the ring. Now, our main event today on AIWF Mid-Atlantic Wrestling will be one of those matches as Notorious Drake Tungsten and Matt Houston put the AIWF World Tag Team titles on the line against Tropic Thunder. And that's going to be our main event today, which ought to be pretty dang good. But we're going to take a quick break right now, and when we come back, I want to get into this Chuck King issue just a little bit deeper. And then I got an interesting video to show you. We'll be right back right after this.
AIWF Mid-Atlantic Wrestling fans, check out King's Hot Dog, located down at Rural Hall, North Carolina, Village Square Plaza, right off of Highway 52, exit 118, where you can find anything from corn dogs, BLTs, chuck wagon, barbecue, and the world-famous King Dog. That's right, 14 inches, 2 pounds of meat, and with drive-through service available if you're in a hurry, stop on by today, Village Square Plaza, Rural Hall.
Some good hot dog, man.
Hello, wrestling fans. Rick Deezel here for Leisure Time Rentals. At Leisure Time, we have quality brand name furniture for your entire home at unbeatable prices. And as always, there's no credit check. Also, free delivery and setup are available. So the next time you need furniture, appliances, electronics, or computers, go to the company that was born right here in North Carolina. Our friendly staff is ready to approve you today. Leisure Time. Get what you want at a price you can afford. Okay, welcome back to the program. Now, as I said before the commercial break, Chuck King, he's been MIA, missing in action, from AIWF Mid-Atlantic for a while, and no one really understood. Well, Chuck King returned in Pelham to make this wild announcement that's going to affect AIWF Mid-Atlantic TV over the next few weeks. And as I said, our main event on this episode will feature the AIWF World Tag Team title match that he was talking about. But there's something going on with Chuck, and not too many people see it out in the crowd. You know, not too many people see it outside the building. Or if you're a fan, you don't see it. But if you're with Chuck King in the back, in the dressing room, outside, or I mean, you know, if you're one of the boys, you see that something is bothering Chuck King. Now, as many of you know, Rick Deezel has been with the AIWF for a long freaking time. I've been here since pretty much day one of this company. I've had my ups and downs with the AIWF. I've been promoted to this job. I've been demoted to that job. And one thing has always been consistent with this company, and that's how they treat you over time. They are real good to you when they start out as far as putting you in this position, but then as time goes by, they sort of drift away from you. Well, I caught Chuck backstage in Reidsville, North Carolina recently. And I sat down with Chuck and I had a conversation with him. Now, keep in mind that the AIWF, for one reason or another, the way they explain it is the fact that Rick Deezel is a loose cannon. And Rick Deezel, you never know what he's gonna do because he's, you know, according to the AIWF, I might just be crazy. But, you know, and here's my thing. If I'm so freaking crazy, why do they keep sticking me in front of these cameras? Why have they changed the format of this television show yet again and stick me in front of it? Why do they have me co-hosting Double DQ Radio on Sunday nights at 9 on TalkShoe.com? Cheap plug. And why do they every once in a while stick these cameras in my face and say, hey, we need another Like It or Not, which we got an interesting one coming up pretty soon. Fact of the matter is that Rick Deezel means ratings. And they stick Rick Deezel in front of these cameras because they know that when he does do something weird or off the wall, people are going to watch. So that's how I get these cushiony little jobs. But getting back to the Chuck King thing, I sat down with Chuck with a camera following me around like they always do, and I talked to him a little bit about what's going on. And I want to show you that video right now. So let's go check that out.
Well, y'all think about it. I tell you what, y'all got me so daggone discombobulated. I'm starting to smoke cigarettes again. It's just killing me now. I don't know what y'all want me to do. Well, maybe I'll talk to you Monday. All right.
Y'all
right, man? Man, I'll tell you. It just keeps going and going. I'm smoking cigarettes again. This mess with the higher-ups.
They're
not talking to me, man. I don't understand.
I've been wondering what was bothering you, but I feel you, man. Because, you know, I was with this company since day one. And they've given me this job behind the scenes, that job behind the scenes, promoted me to this, demoted me to that. And one thing was always a constant is that they would get where they wouldn't talk to.
And what did you do?
I didn't know what to do. I mean, you know me, I buck a system all the time anyhow.
Well, yeah, you've got that way.
That's why the camera follows me around everywhere. I mean, sorry, but they just
bring it with you, right?
Well, they follow me everywhere I go. They don't ever know when I'm going to say something or do something.
That's cool. I mean, you think that, you know, I don't mind the job if they just give me, you know, a little leniency here to do things, but now it's just like they started out that way, and now it's...
They don't talk to me.
Oh, at all. It's like I tried to pull teeth right then, and it's like they were pulling mine back.
You make phone calls, they don't answer. They don't call you back. I know, man. I've been through it.
I get the answer machine. It's terrible, man.
Back when I started, they didn't have a whole lot of answer machines. When I started,
send a letter, right?
Yeah, I'd send a letter and hope to get a return. But
well, see, man, you're the only one I can talk to because I mean, you've been through this. You know what's going on. I mean, it's like there's something in the background that they're not telling me, and it's almost like somebody's trying to pull the rug out from under me. I just can't pinpoint where it's coming from and why. I mean, it's why? Somebody's got something against me. I just don't know. I mean, you know, that match with Ricky and Jimmy up in Pelham. I mean,
you've done that.
And it's like they were all happy and great about that. And then Ricky takes the belt and hey, great. And then after that it was like gone. I mean, I'll do whatever they ask me to do, but I mean it's like give me some leniency to let me have a little bit of something in there to change it up. But, you know, I mean, God, I got nobody to turn. I mean, it's just like everybody don't want to talk to me. It's like they just stay away from Chuck. Stay away from Chuck. Don't get near him. Don't do anything, you know. You're the only one at least comes out and says, what's up? I see something's wrong. What's going on? And I appreciate it too, man, but you know, something's got to give.
I'll tell you what, man. Good luck. If you need to talk, I'm here for you. I've been there. I know what you're going through.
Next time you say one of these in my hand, just kick me.
All right.
Yeah,
just call me if you need.
Anyway.
Call me if you need anything.
Thank you, man.
All right, there you go. Chuck King having to deal with the AIWF powers that be, and according to Chuck, I mean, they're not talking to him anymore. And I don't know why, but I will tell you this. And Chuck, if you're out there watching, buddy, I'm going to be there for you, just like I told you when I shook your hand. I know what you're going through. I've dealt with these crackheads before. I know what's going on. So talk to me, brother. If you ever need anybody, I'm here for you. Call me, text me, email me, whatever the medium is nowadays that people communicate with each other with. But let's stay in touch, and I will help you through this, man. I've been there. I know what you're going through. We're going to take a quick commercial break, and when we come back, we're going to have our main event, Drake Tungsten, Matt Houston versus Tropic Thunder for the AIWF World Tag Team Title. Back, I when you disappeared, you appeared an hour later, choosing which to use. I got a brand new tattoo, all the colors in it remind me of you. I got a brand new tattoo, all the colors in it remind me of you. The blue's for the bruise that you left in my heart, and the red is for the color we're about to paint. Hello, wrestling fans. Rick Deezel here for Leisure Time Rentals. At Leisure Time, we have quality brand name furniture for your entire home at unbeatable prices. And as always, there's no credit check. Also, free delivery and setup are available. So the next time you need furniture, appliances, electronics, or computers, go to the company that was born right here in North Carolina. Our friendly staff is ready to approve you today. Leisure Time. Get what you want at a price you can afford.
Three, and we're about ready to get this AIWF World Tag Team title match underway. Starting for Tropic Thunder, Sebastian Cruz, the smaller of the two, and starting for Team Notorious, Drake Tungsten. These two teams have never even really laid eyes on each other, ladies and gentlemen. This is Sebastian Cruz, first time coming down into the Mid-Atlantic area. Cole, the Flying Hawaiian, his tag team partner outside the ring, has made several trips down to the Asheboro area. Drake Tungsten working over that arm into a hammerlock. Sebastian Cruz trying to figure out a way up. Nice move with a single leg takedown. Sebastian Cruz getting a little bit of extra there on Drake Tungsten. Tungsten complaining to referee JR. Saying that was illegal. Even Kevin Williams up in the fracas there. Sebastian Cruz looks like he's saying, I was just getting a little massage there, old dude. Now Keiko flies the wire. You can just see the drool dripping off the ladies' chins out there in the front row for this one. Nice lockup. Tungsten right back to that arm twist. Keiko with a flip and another flip. Oh, handstand. Oh, nice reversal from Keiko. Go behind. Oh. Looks like he's digging some fingernails into the back of Drake Tungsten. Tungsten got a bit of a frustrated look on his face. It's amazing. What amazes me is the fact that, Team Notorious is so hated in the Pelham area that this team comes in from the very first time that these fans laid eyes on this team. They were top fan favorites right here in Pelham, but that just goes to show you how hated the old school mafia is in the Mid-Atlantic area. They used to try to get the crowd behind him. Drake Tungsten even trying to lead the cheers, but it's not happening. The Tropic Thunder not having any problems getting support from this crowd. Now, Matt Houston. Sebastian Cruz locking up for the first time. Houston with a nice headlock. Cinching it in tight. Cruz with a couple of forearms to the midsection. Shoots him off. Oh, nice shoulder tackle from Matt Houston. Big arm hip toss. Looks like Notorious can't quite get their footings here. They're having a real hard time getting a game plan together against this young team. These kids are hungry. This is a shot at the most recognized title they have probably ever had a chance to lay their hands on. They win this and their world changes completely overnight. Nice.
Little birds are driving right now, fans. They're pulling and they're dropping like flies here. Just a few minutes of
action. No sailing down here. I mean, this building, more than any building I believe I have seen in a long, long time, makes you bring your wrestling skills, your wrestling game
You have to bring it when you come to this building, because there is no high flying, no moonsaults, no off the top rope maneuvers. You have to wrestle your way to a victory when you come to Pelham. And I do believe that that fact alone works in the favor of Notorious. Because Notorious is a wrestling team. They're not high flyers. They are a wrestling team. Okay, Cole with a nice arm bar. Houston backs him into the corner. Referee J right there. Ooh! Shot to the midsection. Another hard shot to the jaw. Houston with an Irish whip. Reversal. Oh, Kate Cole trying to get years ago. Spring Jam debuted. And this year, 2011, is going to be a good one. Ricky Morton of the Rock and Roll Express, the AIW World Heavyweight Champion, will be coming back to the Mid-Atlantic area for Spring Jam this year. He will be in the main event. And don't forget, the night before, on the 20th of May, AIW Mid-Atlantic Wrestling will be at the Colonial Inn and Suites in Reidsville, North Carolina for the return. Return to Reidsville on Friday night, May the 20th. Ricky Morton, Rock and Roll Express will be there for that one. Big cards coming. It's AIWF Mid-Atlantic Wrestling making its way around the Mid-Atlantic area, dominating, invigorating, and taking over. Matt Houston with an armbar now on Sebastian Cruz. Don't forget also, ladies and gentlemen, to check out AIWFMidAtlantic.com, the official website of the AIWF Mid-Atlantic area. Or check out AIWFWrestling.net for not only information and news from the Mid-Atlantic area, but all over the AIWF territories and affiliates. 50 strong, 8 countries. AIWF dominating the independent wrestling circuit. Greg Tungsten now getting a little choke in outside. No tag there, but the referee was busy on the other side. Sebastian Cruz trying to make his way over to Kekoa, but no, Greg Tungsten right there to cut him off. Oh my God! Ladies, that right there, he could have broke the wrist of Sebastian Cruz. It looks like now, I'm not really sure that Notorious, Tungsten, and Houston took this young team seriously when they first walked in today. But I'm sure they're taking a whole different look at them now, because you can actually see the different expression on Drake Tungsten's face as he is working over Sebastian Cruz. Matt Houston with a knee right to the shoulder. They're trying their best to injure this kid. What seems to be Notorious thinking that this team is just a joke. Looks like now they're taking a whole different outlook. Now it looks like they're out to injure the young Sebastian Cruz. Matt Houston with a hard right hand sends the youngster down. Irish whip. Nice sunset flip. Where's the ref? Ref not in position. One, two, two count only. Then Matt Houston kicks out. Oh, hard elbow. Got a shot for Kay Cole. Sends him almost into the front row. Like I said before, ladies and gentlemen, you have to wrestle when you come to Pelham. No high flying here. Cruz seems to be in a lot of pain on that left shoulder. Matt Houston throwing those hard forearms in, taunting Kay Cole yet again, drawing him in. Small package. Small package. Get out of the ring, Kay Cole. You can't stand in there and tell the ref to turn around. He's not going to turn around until you get out of the ring. One, two, and no. All those new champions. Hard clothesline. Basie Cruz is down. Keiko's getting extremely frustrated outside the ring, but this is where the old school mafia shines. This is where Notorious and any member of the old school mafia, any team, of whether it's Notorious or the Mid-Atlantic Outlaws or Jimmy Love and any other member, this is where they shine. Oh, nice move from Sebastian Cruz. As Matt Houston took a little too long to play and flirt with the camera. Nice! Tag in, here comes Kate Cole, hard clothesline, another hard clothesline. Whoa, hard chops! Another double chop, sends Notorious down, drop kick! Whoa, beautiful neck breaker! One, two! Sebastian Cruz back in. Nice drop kick from Sebastian Cruz. All four men going at it now. Keiko and Matt Houston are the two legal members of this, two legal men in the ring. Sebastian Cruz and Drake Thompson outside. Oh my God! That nearly snapped Keiko in half. Matt Houston with a chair now. The fans are going crazy. They're out of their seat, on their feet. Keikoa is still dazed from that hard slam. Looks like that did not work out for Matt Houston. Oh, there it is. There's the super kick we've heard about. One, two, three, we have new champions. We have new champions and the crowd is on their feet. We have new AIWF World Heavyweight Champions, Tropic Thunder from out of nowhere, have defeated Notorious Drake Thompson and Matt Houston, and Kevin Williams is irate. There they are. Ladies and gentlemen, the brand new AIWF World Tag Team Champions, Sebastian Cruz, Keiko the Flying Hawaiian. They are Tropic Thunder, and this